Hey everyone, my name is Laura Reich of Envision Advertising, and for those of you who don't know, I am a social media marketing manager and a graphic designer. So what that means for you is I help solopreneurs build their business through relationship connecting, social media, creative design, and so much more on a smaller scale for them to be able to handle. Today I'm going to go over ConvertKit and how to create automations for your funnels to ensure that you are connecting some of your funnels together, but you're also not oversending emails and you can track who is interested in what. So I've set up a couple of rules down here for a free video training that I'm offering. And I'll show you, all you have to do is go to automations and then add a rule. So what I want is when someone clicks on a link, I created a thank you page. So I put my link in here and it's my bonus for anybody that's already on my list for some other freemium that I've offered. Now what I want to do is I want to title this trigger so that I know, even though I'm going to use this link for multiple triggers, I know which trigger to put in the email. So what I'm going to do is, this one is for my blogging templates. And I'm going to say blogging templates to videos. And then I want them, if they click on this link, to have to subscribe to my new sequence that's already set up in their free training. They hadn't signed up for the free training videos, but I'm offering it to them in an email as a bonus. So if they click on this link in the email, I want them to automatically be subscribed to that because they're showing interest. Then I want to take it one step further and I want to add a trigger and say I want them to unsubscribe from a sequence. So I want them to unsubscribe from blogging templates. And so I'm going to put that sequence in here. The reason I do so is because if I already offered them this bonus, I don't want them to continually get the blogging templates emails that I'm sending. They've already received the templates, but now I've just been sending them more information and content on blogging, which they can get from my free training videos. So then I would click Save Rule. When you go back to your automations, you can see that you will be able to pick what trigger it is down here. It'll have the triggers that you've set up with the names that you've provided. So now what you're going to do is you're going to go to your sequence series. And for this sequence, I'm going to go into blogging templates. In here, this is the first series of emails that they get with their templates and other information. Then you'll see the bonus email down here. This is my bonus email I've written for them, and this click here button I want to make sure is actually linked with the trigger. So when you click on link, it's not just going to be a link that you put in there, an HTTP. You're actually going to insert the link trigger. So you do not want to just copy and paste your link in here. That's not going to actually trigger the automation rule that you have. So you're going to click on link triggers here, and then you'll see the triggers that you actually just created. Now make sure you choose the right trigger so it unsubscribes them from the right sequence. So we are in the blogging template sequence, so I'm going to choose free videos and blogging templates. That way now ConvertKit knows when they click on this that they are to unsubscribe them from blogging templates and subscribe them to the new sequence called free videos. So I click insert, I click save, and we're good to go. That way then, if I did start other emails down here past this bonus with more information, it's still pertaining to blogging for those who don't care about the free videos or are not interested in the free videos, but they're still interested in blogging. For those of who were interested in the free video bonus, they're going to get free videos with blogging and other things included, so they don't need to have the following emails. Another way that you can do this is when I go to sequence, I have a freemium that I set up, which is just one email, and it gives them a Facebook group calendar download where they can put it up into Google Calendar, into iCalendar, whatever they use, and it gives them a calendar of what groups to participate in on which days, what are promo days, things like that, what are days you can actually just interact with people and ask questions. And that's the only email I want to send them because it's not a series, I'm not trying to send anything, I'm just offering value. So what I did is I created this bonus the second day after, and I said, hey, I hope you're liking everything. Click here if you want to get my free email series. So then that way on those free videos that I'm giving out for training, they would be able to actually sign up for one of my longer term freemiums that I'm offering via email. Now what I can do is I can actually take now, since this is set up with a trigger, you can see, I'll click here and show you, it's set up with the Facebook calendar bonus training video trigger. So now what I can do is those who click this are automatically going to be unsubscribed from Facebook group calendar sequence. What I could do is I could duplicate this email right here, and so I could say something along the lines of, oh my gosh, you're missing out, you didn't click and get my free videos for solopreneur online marketing training. You know, this is your last opportunity, whatever you want to say, but you can safely send this email now to this list, knowing that those who have already clicked on the previous email have been unsubscribed. So they're not going to continually get my pitch to sign up for my new sequence. So that's my tip today for you guys for automations and sequences with ConvertKit. If you guys have any questions, I would love to discuss with you in the chat below. Go ahead and post it in there and we will discuss. Thanks.